Andy's experience as well. I want to get to Ashley here calling from Frisco, Texas. Hey, Ashley, you're live on Truth Wanted. What's up?
Hey, Ashley.
Hey.
How's it going?
I'm happy to be on.
Cool, cool.
Oh, it's going good. I'm having a good Friday night.
Yes, that is awesome. Well, I see that you wanted to talk to us about the MLM Young Living, right?
Yeah, I did.
Okay. So tell me about that.
So, yeah. So I have an aunt that actually sells for Young Living. And I'm honestly convinced that it's kind of cultish. And honestly, I don't think MLMs at all are good. I think they just take advantage of people. But particularly Young Living has such a background of, like, scandal with their, like, founder, Gary Young. He used to pretend that he was a doctor, and he actually, like, killed a baby by, like, birthing it in water and, like, holding it underwater for a long time. And, like, he was just, like, a really, really, like, fucked up dude.
Yikes.
Like, I just thought, yeah, right?
You don't get any good positive outlooks on life from that kind of experience. I think, I don't know, maybe that's not true, but, like, I can't imagine, right?
Yeah. It's just really
Can I just pick up on something you said there, Ashley? You said that MLM sound, this MLM seems cult-like. Stephen Hassan, cult expert, has made mention before. I believe that his bite model applies to many different kinds of groups, and MLMs are just one of the kinds that fit that. Political groups as well, all sorts of kind of groups can fit the model. And really, I think something Chris Shelton said, I hope I'm not misquoting this, I probably am when I'm saying it, but at its heart, a cult is an abusive relationship. And really, that's what I think we're looking at when we do look at a lot of MLMs there. I'm not like as clued in on all the specifics of Young Living as perhaps I should be. Obviously, what you said there is troubling. But yeah, no, it's... Yeah, it doesn't surprise me to hear you say that. And I think you're probably on the right track with that. If you're not familiar with Stephen Hassan's bite model, BITE, you can Google that and have a look at that. It might help provide some insight.
I've heard of the bite model from
Okay, cool.
Yeah, he does a lot.
Yeah, okay, perfect. Yeah.
Yeah, so I honestly, Ashley, you know, if I hear it's an MLM, I am actually going to make the assumption that it's a cult. Before I'm going to make the assumption that it's not. You know what I mean? Like, there's so many examples out there. And you know, it's not always going to be a cult in the traditional sense, but there is going to be, I'm going to call it like a workplace abuse of a kind of environment if we're talking about people's working spaces, because there are ideas that are put into people's heads to make them work harder for goals that are just not realistic for them to achieve. If you go on, like, there's a great subreddit called Anti-MLM that gives a lot of great examples of different kinds of cults. Of course, Young Living is one of the most talked about ones on there as far as the kinds of activities and stunts that they try to pull. And it's incredibly exploitative. There's the model, is built on exploitation. I mean, like, there's a reason why, you know, you are probably going to get a message from someone in Young Living that I might not, because there's a target demographic they're shooting for. You know, and just like Andy was saying earlier, a lot of these kinds of groups especially want to take advantage of people's emotional turmoil or changes in life where they're going to be the most open to exploitation. And that's where you find people who join MLMs too. People usually do not join MLMs when things are going absolutely fantastic in their lives. Not saying that's the case for everybody, but I know several people who get MLMs because they're hard on their luck. And this sounds like a good way to make cash. And maybe this is a way for them to feel a sense of self-respect because they, quote unquote, own their own business and they do all these things. So, yeah, I'm sorry for your aunt. But, you know, if I was to have a conversation with her about it, I would be very stark and be very frank and say, look, these are people's experiences. And this isn't just people writing because they got burned out from a bad company. This is really bad. This is court level cases bad, you know? So,
yeah, no.
I always say with that kind of thing, Ashley, try to protect your relationship with your aunt. Talk to her, connect to her, connect with her on things that aren't Young Living. Maintain that and maybe don't just go in all guns blazing saying, it's a cult.
Yeah.
Just maybe learn about other groups that are similar and talk to her about that.
Yeah, no, I've actually talked to her and she just doesn't believe the information. Mm. She just says that it's all lies and fake news, quote unquote.
Yeah, there is that aspect to it as well. I guess it's one of those things you just kind of hope that they see through it sooner or later, and you just stick it out and be there. I guess. I mean,
well, you know, Ashley, exactly. I bet there's enough people who are involved in Young Living out there that there are ex-members that will probably be willing to sit down and have a conversation with your mom, or sorry, mom, aunt. If they're willing, I'm serious. You know, like sometimes that kind of stuff can really wake people up. But I don't know. I mean, there's going to be different routes, but do not concede, right? At least don't concede as much as you can, because like, this is dangerous. You know, this is dangerous. This isn't a maybe kind of, this isn't a, oh, well, you know, there's some advantages here. Like, no. The record has been proven on Young Living, right? Like there's enough out there to know it's just not going to be good, and there's better opportunities. So that would be my only advice with that. You know, I try to be as giving as I can with a lot of this stuff, but that stuff, that's playing with fire. It really is. You can get into a lot of trouble with that.
Exactly.
So anyway, Ashley, thanks again for calling in. I hope we got gave you some advice on that and got to, I know just talking about it probably helps too, right?
Yeah, no, I appreciate it.
Oh, by the way, Ashley, there's a channel called The Recovering Hun, but I did a video on there recently with the host, and she talks a lot about MLMs and stuff. If you haven't seen that, The Recovering Hun, but it might be useful.
And if you want, so Genetically Modified Skeptic, his wife is starting up a channel, I think specifically talking about Young Living.
I thought you were going to say starting up an MLM then.
No, but she's talking about Young Living and some other MLMs, so that's one to look out for too, I think. And of course, Genetically Modified Skeptic is talked about too. But anyway, we're going to get to some other callers here. Thanks again, Ashley, for calling in, and I hope to hear from you again.
Yeah, thanks. Yep. Talk to you later.
Have a great one. MLMs, bad business. I would love to talk to, I think I should, if there's any ex-MLM members that are interested in talking about their experiences on this program, I would love to have you on. So like, you know, email at truth@atheist-community.org. I'd love to see some people's experiences with that. And maybe we can make a whole show out of it. We'll see. Okay, again, just going through the call.